Hello! Bit of an update video today. Recently I reviewed the FullSpeed Toothpick and lots of people told me that Kebab FPV came up with the name. Yes, we got it. He's also quite happy with the name being used on the FullSpeed Toothpick, just to let everybody know. Now, I really enjoyed flying this, but the problem I was having is it kept going out of range. I mean, it's got its own D8 compatible receiver, it's not SPI or anything, but one of the problems is it's so fast that by the time you're like 5 seconds down the road, you're pretty much at the end of the signal range. So I wanted to put something like an XM Plus inside. Now, this is pretty straightforward on this one. It's just a little change from what's in there. It's not quite a swap out because the included receiver is non-inverted. An S-bus receiver like the XM Plus here is. So we just have to find another pin. So I'll just show you what I'm doing quickly and then we'll take it out and have a nice fly and see how far we can get. Well, this looks fairly simple. What I've done, I've just unscrewed the top. So there's a screw there and a screw there. This lifts off, this pushes through, and I've just unplugged the camera for now. And if we have a look at where the receiver goes into, you can see it's got its ground 5-volt and signal wire. This is the non-inverted, and we need to use this pin here, which is the inverted for our S-bus. So really a case of just desoldering these and putting ones back there, there, and there. And obviously getting rid of this receiver itself. So let's do that bit next. So here's our result, here's my XM Plus, and we've got the three connections there. Not super clean, but good enough. I've just bound it up and that's all okay. The only thing I've changed in Betaflight is I've got the RSSI version of this flash. So I've used AUX 12 as my RSSI, and I'm hoping this should just fit in there and I'll be able to take the antennas and use a bit of zip tie to get them going out the arms or something. But let's see if it all goes back together nicely now. And here's our finished product. We've just taken the XM Plus antennas and routed them out on cable ties with a bit of heat shrink applied. Hopefully won't bend around enough to catch a prop there. Of course, we've probably added just a couple of grams, what with the receiver and a little bit of heat shrink and cable ties, but I think that's worth it for what we can hopefully get from it. So let's stop talking about it. Let's go fly it and see if we can get a bit further this time.
So up we go, and I've gone back to the same area that I did previously because at this point it was already bleeping and complaining that telemetry was critical and it was all going to die. So I'm just going to go along to the end of the little row here and go back again. Again, I'm not after like mega range. I don't want to go like kilometers on this thing, but I just want to be able to sort of fly it around without really worrying about it. And that's pretty much what an XM Plus gives me. I mean, even with the sort of antennas kind of short on the arms like that, not in an ideal position, you can still go, you know, hundreds and hundreds of meters quite low down without ever really worrying about it. It's just going to work fine. So I settled in to have a nice little fly around here, but I didn't bank on the fact that I'd kind of forgotten how to fly this a little bit, especially the power loop. So one thing I managed to do was drew a power loop, didn't take the power off quickly enough, and stuck it straight into a tree. Well, it's no problem to get, but what I did do is rip a couple of props a little bit, and then I found out I'd forgotten to bring spare props with me. So the flights from now on are going to be a little bit shaky because we've got some really quite ragged props now, but it still works fine. Now, I wanted to fly in 2S here, which I'm doing, because somebody asked me in the comments, they said they thought 3S was like a little bit much for the space they had, and how was it in 2S? And the answer to that is very good. There's a little bit of top-end power loss. You can feel it in the punch-outs and when you are sort of trying to get max speed. I should explain that flying on a sort of 3S high-voltage battery gives a sort of crazy mental speed. 2S is like a bit more normal, so you don't really feel like you're losing much. It flies like a regular quad. I personally like it where it's mad and it feels like, I'm hanging on for dear life. But yeah, there's no problem flying this 2S. Again, I had a discussion with NDRC about this and he thought 2S was the way to go on this because you just could not get the power through on 3S. And this is absolutely true. There's a lot of power that just does not get transferred through because the props go fluttering, and you lose a lot of efficiency that way. But that said, you know, I'm happy to fly at 2S, but I like to fly at 3S for the pure madness of it all. And just to make sure that those props were as ragged and as horrible as possible, I decided to stick it in another tree at the end of the battery. And I just walked up the little trail a bit just to find somewhere else to fly. I really like this quad even more now. I mean, I liked it before because I felt you could fly it anywhere, but I didn't like the fact it was like almost constantly telling me it was out of range. But having a quad this small, which you can do so much on and is really quick, which can just go anywhere, is fantastic. So just a small little stupid cut through like this, where they stuck a couple of power lines in, is just perfect. I mean, obviously don't fly into power lines, I didn't tell you to do that, but just you can create spaces from anything. I fly 5 inches down here as well occasionally, and this does not feel sluggish in comparison. I mean, I'm only really getting sort of 30-40% on the throttle, and it's still making me happy. That's the thing about this quad. I'm not out here to try and get amazing GoPro footage, because of course it won't carry anything, and you know, the camera's not the best, it's a bit shonky, and you've just got DVR footage. So it's really just pure joy of flying around on these things and just having a good time. This is what I really like about this sort of class of quad. Anyway, so if you had a toothpick or thinking about getting it but maybe put off because of the whole range thing, a small investment to get something like an XM Plus or whatever the equivalent is for your transmitter is well worth it. So I'd highly recommend both the quad and upgrading a little bit. Oh, and take plenty of spare props with you as well, like I didn't. Those of you that were also keen on the Sailfly X and are questioning, well, why aren't you doing this on the Sailfly? The answer is I am. It will be coming up in a later video, hopefully quite soon. Well, I hope this video has been useful to you, and until next time, I'll catch you later. Bye for now. Well, you've made it to the end of the video, so thanks once again for watching. If you like what you saw, then please consider subscribing, and if you really like what you saw, then be sure to check out the link to my blog for a variety of ways in which you can help support this channel.